A big thanks to all of my Patreon supporters, and a big thanks to all of these donators of $5 or more. Brian D0313, DeadZergling, Radio Raptor, and Vlad Tepish 3176, you all helped make these episodes possible. Howdy, insufferable gaming fans. Your old pal Rosser here. Well, a while back, I lost another bet. So you may notice that my video is flipped horizontally. This is intentional as a condition of the bet, and I have to play Bart vs. the World like this for an hour. So my controls are reversed. If I hit right, he goes left. If I hit left, he goes right, from what I'm seeing. That's gonna make things a little tricky. I mean, this game is not good under the best circumstances, so let's just hit start and get to it. Now we've got a lot of mini games we can play. All they're good for, really, is getting extra lives. I don't think in an hour that's going to become too much of an issue, but we'll see. Now, this game has famously bad controls, as it is. And we're gonna see a lot of that evident as we move forward. See that diamond? Extra life. And I have wasted it. Oh well. I'll worry about that later. For now, let's just try making at least a little bit of progress. You know, I'll do what I can. No promises. We'll start out by getting the rare Krusty collectible for this level, and then climbing back up, which is something you can do. Hopefully I won't get wrecked by all manner of fireworks and whatnot. Although, having the Chinese man with his warrior's ponytail kick my ass, not good for me. Anyway, next we have a great wall, which is a sporting level. Right. My up and down are not reversed. So naturally, oop, I want that extra life. The big diamond's worth an extra life. I also got Lisa there because she will cause a collectible to appear later on in the level. Very disorienting, all in all, I must say. But I am up for the challenge, dammit. I hope. Or maybe not. It could be said that I'm a bit rusty on this game. I practiced a little bit, but I didn't practice it upside damn down. That I certainly didn't do, or backwards, I should say. Not upside down. Upside down's a bit different. Completely different kettle of fish. One that hopefully we won't be having to worry about. Now this is very tricky, because I'm so used to playing this level, you know, completely differently than this. The safe thing to do is to just jump all of these little concrete, or wet cement, or whatever the hell these rough places in the floor are. So we're gonna grab a few collectibles there. Yeah, we got a few, and now we fight the boss of this level. Fu Manchu Burns. Oops. Hold on a second, trying to get my act together here a little bit. Alright. Now, the way this boss works is you can only hit him when his fan is folded. but it requires a certain amount of timing, which, let's face it, hard enough under optimal circumstances. Say nothing of having my controls reverse-ed. So what's the plot of this game, you might ask? Well, it's basically nonsense. For some reason, Mr. Burns wants the Simpsons dead. I mean, I guess this game was made during a point in the show where that was a recurring... where the Simpsons had repeatedly foiled him at some stuff. But, you know, the show didn't stay in that direction for very long, so... crap. So, you know, it's not really particularly relevant now. But anyway, that's the first boss down. And now we get to count up my collectibles, which were not enough for an extra life. Next, we're going to... Alaska? Or the North Pole? Or some damn place. North Pole. That's what it is. So again, we don't really have to do these, mini-games, but I guess we... oh, right. Other way. And one more. There we go. And we got one whole collectible, because Sideshow Bob is not the optimal person. Igloo sliding game's easy enough. I'm not even gonna try to do the sliding block puzzles. I'll show it off just to... so you'll see what exactly I am talking about. But, these things, you know, I can do them, but not quickly, and it won't be pretty, and I also keep trying to hit down for up and up for down. But anyway, let us go to the North Pole Ice Cave, and this is most likely where I will be spending the next 53 minutes of game time. If we're being completely realistic. Wow. That actually worked. Shit! I hit right when I should have hit left. Yeah. That's why this is going to be, basically, a disastrous nightmare of an effort. Is this part, man. This part is hellacious under... perfect circumstances, and just so you know, I am trying to go up. Not, in fact, all the way to the bottom. Because up is the way wherein lies victory, and down is certain death. See, I have this method of getting through here that I figured out when I was a kid, and it is effing impossible to do it like this. Where, you know, you land on the ice, and then you take a short hop in the opposite direction to arrest your momentum. And that is not god dang working here now, is it? Nope, 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 nope. We ain't doing so hot. It was to be expected, honestly. You know, I figured that this would be pretty much the major sticking point of this video. I mean, maybe I can kind of work on it some. I'm getting the hang of it. I'm jumping much differently than I did when I was a kid, so... the physics are a little less slippery, which is throwing me off. Amazingly enough, having a non-slippery ice is what's confusing me this time. Now, here we're going to get another crusty collectible, courtesy of Marge. And to do that, we have to jump up and knock these snowballs into that crusty statue, and I'll need to get a little closer there. And be better at timing. Being better at timing helps. And then on my way down, I'll try not to screw up the directions. Past the first break, and there we go. Awesome. Another great crusty collectible achieved. So in this game, in order to run, you have to hold the A button, but A button is also jump. But to do a regular jump, you hit the A button, but to do a long jump, or a fast jump, you have to hit tap A and hold B. But if you keep holding B and A, then you slide when you land. So basically, it's all just a huge damn disaster, from start to finish. But I made it past the first round of ice flows, or not flows, but things. Ice things. That's a pretty good descriptor. Probably should have picked up more lives in level 1. But, you know, since I'm probably gonna die anyway, I can certainly go back and get some more. Let's see, this is the wrong way. But there's a collectible, or not a, yeah, a cheap, junky collectible. I think it's like 15 of them for an extra life, something like that. I don't remember the exact number. That's the only part in the game where that maneuver is applicable. Aww, I saw that coming. And that was a game over. So now, I get to start all over again. Let's do some Simpsons trivia to kickstart things on this one. Oh right, it's backwards. Where are Selma and this is the DMV at the Motor Vehicle Department. Yep. I don't have to read all of these because I played this so many times as a kid. What gift did Homer a bowling ball? Well, how did Bart try to cheer Lisa up when she was depressed? He imitated Homer. Made rude. Called Moe's. Yeah. I mean, he called Moe's a lot during the old episodes. I don't know if he still does that very often. Doesn't seem like it, does it? Alright, let's see if I can get this without borking it up. I did! Huzzah! I'm a life ahead. And while we're at it, we'll try to get some collectibles. You know, just for the sake of giving myself a better chance later in the game. It could be great. You know what? Let's just go all the way to the top, and then we'll work things from top to bottom. Yeah, that seems like a good plan. Not a great plan, mind you. There's another diamond that I want. The question is, can I get it without getting myself super murdered? And the answer is, probably not. But I'm a try. And I failed. I'm gonna have to jump harder than that if I want that thing. That's for dick dangly daggum sure. Need a big jump, big jump. Big running jump. I made it! Yay, more lives! Okay, let's get the hell out of here and continue on, shall we? We shall. Again, get the collectible here. Line back up, and if I'm very lucky, I'll be able to get some Bartman icons and fly myself to some more 1-ups. That's right, Bartman. He's like Batman, but with Bart. there was a very famous song in the 90s that was on all the radios. That's another life. I'm gonna get that first. There we go. Outstanding. You know what? I think that's enough lives, honestly. Because if I go for the Bartman and miss, I'm going to be kinda dead. Ah, what the hell. He who dares wins, right? Let's grab those one-ups. It would help if I wasn't going in the opposite direction. There was not another one up there. I guess it was in the upper, what's now the upper right corner. I think we've done well enough for this first level to get the lives that we have, though. So with that in mind, I take a cherry bomb to the face. Stop cherry bombing me in the face, you rat bastards, you. They're not gonna do it. They're gonna keep cherry bombing me in the face. It's kind of a problem. Alright, back to the Great Wall. We'll get this sorted out. Alright. Which propels me to the left. And up, not down. See, that's the problem. I keep thinking that all the controls are reversed. Which just really throws me off for some reason. Having the controls off or reversed throws you off? You don't say, you would say to me, and to that I would reply, shut up. I don't see you doing it. Unless you are, in which case, good job. Go up top for the win, for the grab, also for the win. No one wins in a game of Bart versus the World, honestly. And let's just miss every single collectible on the way. Why not? It's trickier to get the hitboxes of the crusty heads than you think it is, honestly. It's a bit strange, to say the least. Loose hitbox, all in all. Okay, gotta do this again. Best chance, stay on this side. And get good at jumping. Or dodging, or some damn thing. There we go. There's kind of a timing to it. I'm a little bit rusty, to say the least. I don't want to accidentally jump and get myself hit, if I can help it. Thought for sure that would get him. I am bad at the timing today. I used to have it down to a science, man. That was a long time ago. Very long time ago. You know what? Shoot like crazy. If it works for Blitzball, it'll work for firefights. With firecrackers. Alright. Dongshi indeed. Not enough crusty heads to get a life. Naturally. Figures. And we'll go ahead and do these again, just on the off chance that I make it past this world. It's not super likely. Let's go for mill houses this time. Oh, I was looking at the left side. I should have been looking at the right side. It does tend to throw me off. And we made it. Yeah, that was a good one. That was four crusty heads. That was a good haul. So if you're playing the jackpot, go for autos. Is he enough? Alright, here's my bane again, the ice cave, but hopefully with enough lives to make it through this time. You know what? Let's just take things a little slower. And that was a terrible mistake, because now everything's falling like mad. And I'm still terrible at hitting the correct direction. Ah, everything's so off. Just run for it, boy. Run for it. Yeehaw! Whoop-de-doo, whoop-de-doo. And take a shot to the head. Alright. We'll just, try to worm our way up here. I am not going for secrets and lives in this level, because, frankly, it's just too dangerous at this point. You know, if I can make it to World 3, I'll be amazed and shocked. Because, you know, after this, we've got another extremely difficult level for as far as jumping goes. And the precision I have is just hovering somewhere around 25 to 30% of what it should be, if we're being generous. Although I do like this new method of jumping up these that I've found today, because my old method just wasn't cutting it very well. Like before, I would never let off of the run buttons. I just hold them down forever. But this is working pretty well. Let's see, I think this is the correct way. Is it? It was. Non-stick surface ice. I love it. Get those sandpaper shoes greased up. That didn't make a lick of sense.
Oh yeah, your face doesn't make a lick of sense.
Shut up, brain, or I'll poke you with a Q-tip. Alright. The hard part hath approached, or at least the part that's most likely to cause my demise. Whoa. Almost, screwed that one up. And now the bubbles. And I was just a tad off on that. You gotta land on the bubbles, or bounce off of the bubbles, when they're at their absolute, bubbliest. If you're too late, you're screwed. If you're a bit too soon, also screwed. And you have to be very precise with your jumps. And I can't do that with this setup, with my controls reversed. It just ain't possible. Alright. Made that one. Shit! Shit! Well, at least it didn't take me 5 or 6 episodes to make it this far. Not that, you know, you would expect it to, but it's a struggle, I'll tell you that much. If I wasn't an old hand at this game, you know, we wouldn't have even seen me get this far. I think this is where this particular run is going to end. I see us starting over in the very near future. Don't you? Seems like it's bound to happen. Foggles! You just, I mean, if you've ever tried to unlearn how to ride a bike, it's kinda like that. Like, if you try to, if you need to deliberately fall off of a bike, it's very difficult to force yourself to do it. And that's what we're dealing with here. Ugh. I don't want to have to go through all of this crap every time. I really don't. Really, really don't. So I probably won't. And right. Can't just plain hit the damn button. Lord knows. That would be convenient. I'm so easily confused at this point. Alright, we're gonna get one extra life here. I hope. That was a miss! Which is fine, because I also forgot to find Maggie there. So, it would have been a waste of my time any damn way. You know, like it tends to be. Alright, get the crusty junk. Toy junk. As opposed to the very large junk full of angry Chinese that we're on now. I think that something like this would probably have just a whiff of racism about it if you tried to do it today. But, I'm no expert, so maybe I'm just being paranoid, or maybe I'm all wet. You get it? Because I fell in the water? It's a joke. It's a joke. Think that's funny? Think a 10-year-old drowning in the middle of the ocean is funny? Well, it's just a video game, so chill out. It's not real. It's all done with puppets and mirrors. Let's try to get Bartman going. Where is my life? There's two lives there. Okay. And then you hammer the B button to get some speed going. And there is my final life. Outstanding. That was almost looked intentional. So we've got a few extra, well, a couple extra lives, not a lot. So let's try to remember this time, if we can. First of all, not to run directly into the wall repeatedly, if that's okay with you, young Simpson. But anyway, what I was trying to say is to get this and not have to go too far back to tag Lisa as well. Boom. And then naturally I took a tumble. I took two tumbles. Because I'm trying to pick up those collectibles and it's not working out very well for me. Is it now? Not working at all, is it, Steve? I am being very easy on the speed, but I gotta get speed up to make these ramps, so should probably be aware of that situation. And the hitbox on these doors is absolute garbage. So you tend to bounce off from time to time. I don't like it. You don't like it. But it's just the way things are. Alright. Let's see if I can get some collectibles going on here. Nope. And go. I got a few there. If only I'd gotten some more in the previous level, I would feel like I was getting somewhere. But let's just get out of here. Again. Meh meh meh. Meh 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 meh. Alright. Thought I was gonna get the quick kill on that one, but it was not to be. And now I'm getting bombarded by whatever the hell those things are. Come on! Hold your fan, you jerk! And now I'm getting confused with my directions again. There we go. That's better. Almost had an extra life, but I slacked off. I could have done Simpsons trivia and gotten it, but I didn't. Do we even bother with this stuff? No. If I actually make it past this level, then we can worry about it. Run for it, boy! Run like the wind! Run, ye yellow bastard, run! There we go. Whoa! About, wrecked myself on that one. Very little, health going on for me. Fortunately, there isn't a whole lot to kill me, except for falls, which will kill me completely outright. So, it's not like health is a real big concern in this level. I mean, there's some stalactites later on, but by then, I'll be at a checkpoint, so it'll be fine. Piece of cake, right? Right. Mmm, cake. Love that cake. Grab this. 5 hits, and you're on your way. I'll meet you at the bottom. That was ballsy. What if I'd missed with the last shot? Then I'd be down here for nothing, and I'd have to go back up twice. And who wants that? Not me. Up, up, up. Up, 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 up. Let's see if I'm able to make any progress at all this time. It's a long shot. Well, we're not quite there yet. One more ascent. All silent cry the noble boulders. That's a King's Quest VI reference. Those are still socially relevant, right? Right? Like, it's still 1996 somewhere. Wait, that's not true at all. I'm merely insane. Good for me. Whoa, 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 whoa. Easy there, killer. God, I hate these bubbles. No! I bounced too close to the sun. I feel like Icarus soaring aloft on the wings of wax and hubris. No, not the sun. Flew too close to the ceiling is all. Okay, that's one down. I've still got one more bubble to go. And I failed at going past that bubble. You know we're at the end of the level, right? This is basically the final obstacle until we get to an even worse level for jumping. Ah, I could feel that that was wrong as soon as I left the bubble's bounce zone. Like, you know, you've been platforming for long enough, you can just tell when something's just gone bad. Like that one, fuck my donkey. Just right up the donkey ass. And I don't even own a donkey, so I don't know what you're gonna do. I'll have to think of something, I guess. Whoa, whoa, whoa! I'm flipping myself off right now. Because I had that, and then I lost it. And that's the most heartbreaking situation of all, really. You know, having to shoot Old Yeller as maybe a 5 or 6, getting onto a platform after a difficult jump and then falling off, perfect 10. Well, what do you know? We have achieved something. Now, here's the problem. This level's gonna kill me deader than shit. Because this level is all jumping, and you have to do a lot of left and right. Like, a lot. Man, this is... Oh, damn it. I lost it at the end there. You know, like you tend to do. And then I jumped too far, because I thought it would be good for me. But it wasn't good for me, was it? Alright, let's take a quick break and I'll be back in a minute. Okay, I am back now, and I decided to just kind of, start here. Not a lot of lives, but, you know, to cut out a little bit of the middleman, for once. If I die again, all bets are off, and it'll be back to the beginning, but for now, you know, we're going to try to get through this crappy level again. Well, maybe not as crappy as the next one, but still pretty bad. And then, although I know there is no way in hell I'll get there this session, there is one level after this in the Hollywood area, which would be pretty much completely impossible to play like this. Actually, all of the levels in Hollywood would be impossible to play like this. But that's neither here nor there, because our first and foremost thought is that we must get past this. I'm starting to regret having ramen noodles for lunch just now. I'm getting too old to be able to digest those things. But they taste so good. Unaccounted because I have a very unrefined palate. But I won't hold it against myself. As long as I can eat for cheap and still be happy, that's all that matters. You know, a couple packs of ramen noodles. Maybe some extra seasonings, like I'll put some garlic powder and some curry powder and maybe some hot sauce. You don't know. Could be anything. Tried to get fancy with that one. That was a mistake. But this isn't. Vroom vroom! Smash that thing. I don't know if it's an icicle or a stalagmite, because it's kind of hard to tell with the color palette being what it is. Could be either. Honestly. And here we have arrived at Bubble Town, yet again. Oh, Bubble Town. Will the curses ever end? Shit, no. A little bit of cursing humor there for you. Oh man, it's gonna be a long way back, isn't it? Yep, that is the case. And screw. Alright, well, we didn't expect much and we were not disappointed. Let's do it to it. Well, this'll give me a chance to get some of those extra lives back, at least. If nothing else. That's what we needed in all of this, right? A few more extra lives. Just kind of get things good to go. All nice and Worked out. Sure, why not? Alright, let's get the Bart man. And then we'll go up here to get our two lives. And then we'll make a bid to this way. And get that. Good. That's a pretty good collection of lives we've got going on. And some temporary invincibility with the head of Jebediah Springfield, who once said, "A noble spirit embiggens the smallest of men." Wise fella, that. Right. Do not reverse your up and down controls on this. I reverse my up and down controls on that. And go back, get the big one up. Diamond. Do it. Beat now! Alright. Jumping, jumping. Don't want to get taken out by any of those wet cement patches, if that is indeed what they are. I remain wholly unconvinced that it is. But we may never know the truth for certain. All I know is that that just keeps on damn happening, and I hate it. Go, Bart, go. For fuck's sake, there's a dragon right there. What are you tarrying for? You don't linger when there's a fire-breathing dragon coming for your ass. You do not... Uh-oh. 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 Wow. I can't remember the last time I died on that. But it was about 10 seconds ago, basically. And now you know. You know what? Let's just stick to the top path here. That was for the best. Yes? Yes. I'll do it some more. Oh, right. Wait, you gotta do these big jumps first. Well, big-ish. Really normal jumps for most platforming paragons of jumpiness. Bart is not one of those. Never has been. Like any The Simpsons game you can name, the jumping isn't good in any of them. Not that I know of or can recall. And I had a lot of The Simpsons games. I had this, I had Bart vs. the Space Mutants, I had Bart's Nightmare. The ones I didn't have were Bartman beats Radioactive Man, and I didn't have Virtual Bart. Which is cool because, from all accounts, they were both equally terrible. I should probably try to win a little better than I am. Just, you know, focus on the dodging, really. And I got blocked by a daggone thing. I'm not gonna make it, am I? Not if I keep playing like this. And that was bad. This is about to be bad, too. Shit, man. I should have stayed on the right side where I feel better about everything. Right, out of these. Damn it! I went from being able to nail this boss every time to struggling with it at the drop of a hat, and I'm not sure why. Alright. No one-ups from that, of course. Why would there be? And here we are again at these damn ice caves. For what, the fourth time? Fifth time? Hell, I don't know. All I know is that the best method out of here is to just run for it. Flea Man Flea. Not to be confused with Flea Man from Castlevania. Now, if anything I could say it was worse than this game, it's having to deal with Flea Men in any Castlevania title. I love the Castlevania games themselves, but those Flea Men, man, they're just the worst. They're horrible. Come on. Help me out here. Oh, I'm not high enough up. Uh-huh. That wasn't a very good one. Is that it? That was it. Lost track of how many hits I had for a time. And it cost me time. And time is the one thing we don't have. Except we kinda do, so let's not stress it. A. A. B. 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 That, of course, being the onomatopoeia for someone with diarrhea trying to fart the alphabet and only getting through the first two letters. I don't know where I'm going with that, but, enjoy the visuals. I know I won't. Like, I think that the vast majority of the time spent in this episode has been on this level. And it's not surprising, because it really is, like, the major roadblock. Oh, man. I was right there, dude. Alright, I've got a few lives, so... Never mind. It won't matter how many lives I have when I put my fist through the screen. I would never take it out on my poor defenseless computer monitor, mostly because I sure as hell can't afford to get a new one if I break this one. It's all about priorities, people. I don't go around breaking my equipment unless it's by accident. Although I have flung a controller hella hard in a fit of rage before once or twice. Shit. This is where my life is, stuck at this point in this cave, until the universe crumbles to dust. Alright, there's one. Now if I can just avoid screwing this one up... And I didn't because I tried to press right. I hate reversed controls. Reverse control challenges. Now, the next time I go to play a normal game, I'm gonna have my brain reversing the controls on that as well. Which is... damn dirty wrong. How many lives did I have when I came to this level? 7 or 8? What am I down to? 4? Awesome. Cool. Amazing. Lovely. Delightful. Superb. Outstanding. Excelsior, etc. And any other synonyms I can't think of right off the bat. Come on, just one more, dude.
Ah! Piece of shit! Oh.
You guys didn't want to see me get anywhere in the next level anyway, did you? You like watching this level over and over again, right? I hope so, because that's what we have to work with. God damn it. This is my punishment for something that I can't disclose yet. But eventually you guys will see what I mean. Someday. 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 Take a hike, indigenous peoples. You are not wanted on your own boat. Up we go. Second verse, same as the first. Everybody do the Bart man. Shit! Whoa, 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 whoa! Hell damn fart. You know, there are times when I feel angry and bitter, but then I remember that I've brought most of this on myself. I really opened myself up for this crap, so I can't be too awfully salty about it. Except for when I can be, but... how often is that, right? Wrong way. Wait, where the hell? Oh, I screwed this one up. Yep, missed the extra life up there. I'm not going to risk going back for it. Because it's just too damn dangerous. It's too damn dangerous. Let's just do the Great Wall and get this over with if we can. I still got at least 10 minutes to put in here. You know what? I don't need the collectibles at this point, because I can't possibly get to the bonus stage anyway. So let's just try to speedrun our way back to the caves, shall we? Alright. Let's do it. Do it to it. I ain't scared of these jumps. If I had any sense, I would be. I'd be damn terrified. Right, hitboxes. Space is warped and time is bendable in this game, so... you know, if you jump into something that's to Bart's right, or left in this case, then naturally that means that he'll take a hit. Because that's how space works, right? I don't mean like outer space, I mean three-dimensional space. Like that basic area where we all navigate our entire lives. There we go. Ah, bloody hell. This is not going too awfully well, is it? Not this time. Just really, you deflected it down that time. Alright, buddy. You are pure evil, and I love it. Ah, bugger. I am not sensing an easy victory this time, but far be it for me to give up, right? See? That hit him somehow. Oh, Captain Crunch. Rearranged my face. There. See, now, if my controls were normal, I'd be really dancing back and forth and getting in close so that I'd be sure of my shot placement. That's, just not possible here. Ah. 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 Horrendous, man. There's no excuse for this piss-poor display of non-gaming. One more? Is it one more? Feels like it should be one more. Almost took a bath on that one. Thank you. I'm just firing to be firing at this point. There. Is that so hard? Yes, yes it was. Absolutely. Alright. We've got time for one more attempt at the ice cave here. Let's just cross our fingers and hope that I can make it across those damnable, dirty, stinking bubbles. Which, you know, gotta get to them first. And I'm taking a lot of risks here. Which I shouldn't be, but I am. All in the name of actually trying to make some progress. I mean, oh, yeah! Blugga, blugga, flugga, blugga, hugga, dugga, dugga. Flying flingerlingies. Etc. Not gonna stop for the crusty snow statue. Try saying that three times fast. Crusty snow statues, crusty snow snats, snoo snoo. It's tricky, a little bit. Like I say, just gonna go straight for the end. Straight for the end, hope for the best, expect the worst, and you shall not be disappointed. But you may be pleasantly surprised, I could make it this time. Oh, I guess that is the end of that. Trek upwards. I'll take whatever help I can get, honestly. I need it. See, there's a Bartman icon in this level, but it would wear off way before I got to the part where I need it. So that's a no-go. Unfortunately. Power of flight would serve me well here, I believe. Actually, the power of flight would serve me well just about anywhere in day-to-day life. Where can I pick that up? What kind of radioactive creature do I need to get bitten by to make that a possibility? I mean, in real life, it doesn't really work like that. But you can dream. Sometimes that's all you have. For instance, now we can dream about screwing this level up. Now, the way this works is, and it is tricky to understand, but you have to land on the ice floe in the direction you want it to go to keep it to maintain its speed. Which is more difficult than you tend to think that it is. I assure you. Especially with these weird angles going on. Now, this one's gonna be the trick, because birds, man. Freaking birds. But if we can maintain a low speed, it'll be a little easier. Or I could just, you know, freaking crash and burn. That's okay, too. Small jumps, probably for the best. And now we have a slightly smaller ice floe to miss jump onto. Like I say, this level is freaking hard enough when your controls are normal. You reverse those puppies, it's just... Well, you can see the result for yourself, right here. I don't want to say it's obnoxiously difficult, because that's not really the case, but just... so awkward. Alright, since I'm here, I'll show you where the next crusty statue is. It's in this igloo. Luckily, you get 60 cherry bombs, and sometimes you need them because these lower tiers are a little difficult to hit properly. But I got it. Alright. Can I make it past one more stretch, which will involve more birds? If I move slowly and methodically, maybe. On a good day, maybe. Well then, today's just gonna have to be a good day. Huh. Maybe this, tiny jump method is... Ooh, that was close. Is, more effective than I gave it credit for. Holy shit, I actually made it. I did not expect that. So that means, let's, quickly grab a few of these, in case, by some miracle, I'm able to get past the boss. With crazy wacky fun bike controls here. Because I could really use a one-up or two for the next area. Let's see, we're going for auto, right? Shit, I was looking at the left side again. Always, I'm looking at the left side. But it's the right side that stops first. So now we're gonna see how many, thingies that Mo drops. Three? I'm betting three. Nope, just two. Well, that's unfortunate. Could have had four. Alright. This boss... is impossible if I don't know which the hell way I'm trying to bounce. Which I don't. Boing! 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 And boing. And then I fell down a hole, but he was dead. I had him. And down a hole again. I freaking hate this reverse controls bullcrap. Pretty much my least favorite thing. There. Avoid them ice kickles. Yeah, you just move on down the road, Mr. Abominable Snowburns. And I made it. Well, I did not expect to get past the North Pole on this video, but since I did, we'll just keep going until I game over. And now we've got Ramsay's Burns in Egypt. I cannot imagine how bad this is going to be. Because there are lots of very painfully difficult jumps and shit. We're just gonna Bartman our way over, holding both A and B to move quickly from one side of the screen to the next. And then we're gonna make sure to jump before we crash into the spikes. Or, alternately, maybe I won't make it. Did you ever think of that? Alright, now is where things get nasty. Very nasty. Oh, man. This just feels wrong, and well, it should. Well, there it is. That was my hour of Bart versus the World with reversed controls and because of screen mirroring. That was a bet I lost to DeadZergling, and now it has been satisfied. So, thank you very much for watching. I deserve this. Until next time, this is your old pal Rosser. Take a drink.